Hi, this is Dr. Hugh Wegwerth. I'm a functional medicine doctor here. And what I really want to talk about today is I've seen lots and lots of floxies, and there's a common theme of when you've been floxed, you have brain problems. You have central nervous system problems. And when that happens, your symptoms can be weird and all over the map. And you go to the conventional system and you tell them, yeah, I feel like I'm going to die. My heart is racing. I have digestive problems. My eye twitches. My leg twitches. You know, my arm twitches. I start to get these weird anxiety problems. When you go there and you go to the conventional system and you tell them all this stuff, they think that you're crazy. There's no way this could actually cause this being fluoroquinolone or FQ, the toxicity, could have caused this problem. But the truth of the matter is, what I want to walk you through on this workshop is the research clearly shows that fluoroquinolones damage brain tissues and they damage your GABA receptor. So I'm going to be going over into that mechanism so then you can actually connect the dots. Because right now, if you have all these weird symptoms and no one can explain why, the reason why is because no doctor has been able to connect the dots. To connect the dots for you. So I've done extensive studies in functional medicine and functional neurology, which is a key element that I studied that is very unique to my approach as we're looking at your neurology and figuring out what's going on from there. So these are all the weird symptoms that you can have. So for example, you've been floxed and now you have central nervous system problems. All these things here, central nervous system or CNS, that's central nervous system. You have depression, anxiety, nervousness, tingling, balance issues, tremors, right? Maybe with your tremors, you start to go out and you reach for something and you start to shake. Or you notice when you walk down the hallway, now you have balance problems. You can't orient yourself on where you are. This has to do with brain problems and in particular your cerebellum, which we'll be going over here in a quick second. Ringing in the ears, you can't feel, feeling overwhelmed, muscle twitches, spontaneous muscle jerks, digestive issues, and chronic fatigue. Ladies and gentlemen, if you have fatigue issues, it's usually brain-centered. If you've been floxed and you have all these neurological tissues, including fatigue, that tells you that your brain has been damaged and your fatigue is actually coming from your brain not functioning well. Because when your brain's been FQ'd, it has to work twice as hard, three times as hard to get the same function done. And consequently, guess what? You are tired. So I'm going to try and explain this in this video here. All right, let's go on to the next slide here. Okay, so if you Google this right here, this is a reference, all right? Now, what we're going to be talking about here is your GABA receptors right here. Is your GABA receptor. So all these articles here, which there's a lot of them, all show that if you had fluoroquinolone toxicity, it affects your GABA receptor. So the reason why I want to bring these research articles to you is that you know that it's not just my opinion. There's actually medical fact clinically that can link all these dots on why your brain's not working right. And the fluoroquinolones severely affect the GABA receptors. Now, then the most important thing is where's GABA at and what does GABA do in your body? Because if it destroys the GABA receptors, that means that your GABA receptors aren't working right, so whatever they were supposed to do is going to stop working or not work as efficient. So let's bring your attention to the slides here. Okay, so here what we're really being talking about is your cerebellum. Okay, your cerebellum means little brain. So let me just orient you. So this would be the front of your head. So this would be, let's say, your nose. Okay. Then you have your mouth, all right, and then you got your head. So just so you know, where we're going to be talking about is your cerebellum right in here. So cerebellum literally means little brain. Now, your cerebellum, let me just get you oriented, it's basically right back here. It kind of looks like your fist right there. Now, your cerebellum is so critical. There's more neurons in your cerebellum right back here than in your entire brain. So let me just say that again. Fluoroquinolones affect your cerebellum. They affect your GABA receptors. And within your brain, the cerebellum is the most densely concentrated neuronal activity or neurons in your body. And in fact, the research has shown that your cerebellum is the most susceptible to toxic damage, whether it be fluoroquinolones, high insulin, high blood sugar, inflammation, poor vitamin D. That's where the damage goes, is your cerebellum. Now, if you've ever had like a sobriety test, or you know what that is, when you lose your balance, they're actually checking your cerebellum. Why? Because the alcohol affects your cerebellum. Why does it do that? Because the cerebellum is the weakest area in your body for damage. That's what they've clinically shown here on the cerebellum. So what happens here, when it comes to the cerebellum here, the GABA receptors are concentrated most heavily on or in your cerebellum, right? So there's lots of GABA receptors sitting right here in your cerebellum. In a minute, I'll explain to you what all this GABA is doing. Now, what the cerebellum is really doing, or its big components here of function, is it acts as a gateway. So what I mean by that is your cerebellum is the gateway for the rest of your brain. This means that all neuronal activity, all nerve flow has to come through your cerebellum, right? So I'm having organ nerve flow coming up to my brain. I'm having where I am in space and orientation, where my fingers are, hot, cold. All this information is coming up to your cerebellum. Now, your cerebellum is the gateway, meaning that if that cerebellum is not working correctly, everything gets through up to your brain. And this is when you get these weird neurological symptoms. For example, if you've ever seen anything like, we've all seen this, Walmart on Black Friday, right? The day before Thanksgiving, they show Walmart, they show like 3,000 people running to get that TV, and people get squashed over and stepped on. This is what happens when your cerebellum is not working correctly, is all the information gets bombarded into your brain, into the rest of your brain, which I showed you, and then this causes weird neurological symptoms. In particular, I'll be showing you this, how this happens. This fires your sympathetic nervous system, which is where you're going to run away from a tiger. This is what's happening, is that cerebellum's not gative, it's not functioning. If it can't inhibit, what really it does is it stops excessive impulses going up to the upper part of your brain. If that's not functioning correctly, guess what? All those nerve impulses go up to your brain, and then you get these weird symptoms. So the cerebellum is the gateway for information coming up and up into your brain here. And this is also critical, information coming down has to go through your cerebellum and out into the rest of your body. So the cerebellum really gives us a key indicator of like how is your brain functioning. And through the functional neurology, we can actually test your cerebellum through having a neurological consult over the internet, over Skype or Zoom or whatever it is. Some of the components of my functional medicine is we're actually doing a functional neurology to see how your brain is functioning, and is there any exercises that we can do to strengthen your brain besides all the other things that we're going to do functionally to get you better. Okay, so this is the cerebellum. Again, it's called little brain. I think that's kind of interesting. So here, what we have here, this is a picture, again, of your cerebellum. Now, this is an MRI scan of your brain. And you can see here, this is where your cerebellum is located. So we're looking at this. Now, this is a person that has severe cerebellum damage and degeneration. Look at this cerebellum to this right in here. You can see how this is cerebellum is severely degenerated. It's shrunk. So now what's happening? You have all this information coming up from your cerebellum. It can't gate it, so it overwhelms the brain. Then you have all these weird neurological problems. Same thing with your cerebellum. The information is going down from your brain, hitting this. It doesn't gate it, so then you have a whole bunch of weird neurological problems again. So this is what GABA does. It relaxes you. It improves sleep. It relieves PMS symptoms. Improves attention deficit disorder. Increases growth hormone. Decreases inflammation and reduces depression. These are just a few things on what GABA does. So if your GABA receptors aren't working in your cerebellum, all these things aren't going to work correctly. It relaxes you. Well, if you don't have the GABA receptors because your cerebellum is damaged, then all those nerves coming in your cerebellum, they blast everything and you can't relax. You're all nervous. You have anxiety. You have night sweats. Your heart feels like it's going to explode out of your chest. You get nervousness. Maybe you think you're even going to die because the damage is so extensive on your cerebellum here. So here, your nervous system is part of it. Your nervous system is combined of two different parts. And I try and use a lot of pictures here. I'm really a pictorial person. So you have your parasympathetic nervous system, which is relax and digest. This is the parasympathetic nervous system that we want to work on. The sympathetic nervous system is, hey, let me run away from a tiger, right? This is when, if you don't have enough GABA receptors or your GABA has been damaged, this is where this fight or flight is increased. And you can see what happens. Your pupils dilate, increase heart rate. Your lungs start to expand because you got to run away. Your stomach doesn't work right. Your gallbladder doesn't work right. Your intestines doesn't work right. And you secrete a lot more epinephrine, norepinephrine. This is what we would call, or this is what I would call a sympathetic storm. You're always anxious. And again, why? Because you have the fluoroquinolone toxicity. It damages your cerebellum. In particular, it damages the GABA receptors in your cerebellum. So what this really webinar is about is not to go over what you do to restore your cerebellum and your brain tissue, which I know how to do, and you can do that. It's just to connect the dots on why you're having all these weird symptomatic symptoms, right, that no one can explain. So your parasympathetic, you can see here, slow heart rate. Stimulates digestion, stimulates your gallbladder, stimulates your small intestine. It's relax and digest. So what happens here is you have your nervous system, okay? You have your sympathetic here and your parasympathetic here, and they need to be equal. If your sympathetic is firing too much, right? If the sympathetic is firing too much, you're going to have a sympathetic storm up to your brain and then a sympathetic storm back down into your organs as well. So we need to balance this so you're nice and smooth and everything's level and everything's firing equally. The problem is once this nervous system gets out of whack because of the fluoroquinolone toxicity and then all the other problems, right? Like maybe you have digestive problems now. Maybe you have inflammation. Maybe you have low vitamin D, high gluten. I mean, they're kind of endless on what happens. Maybe you have hormonal problems, right? So we need to balance all these things to bring the nervous system back into balance. And once you do this, this is when you start to recover. So here, what I've broken it down into, you have your sympathetic nervous system right here, and then your parasympathetic nervous system. So this cerebellum right here, which we've been talking about on this diagram, is right here, okay? So the picture that you're looking over here on your left, this would be your brain cut in half like this. So you're kind of looking down at this just to give you an orientation on where we are on the anatomy of what's happening. So this right here is the cerebellum right here. Now, when it comes to your sympathetic, parasympathetic nervous system, right, they're located. Parasympathetic and sympathetic nervous system are located in your brain. I'm going to show you where they're located at so you can see that. So your sympathetic nervous system is located like right under here, right under your cerebellum. And the sympathetic nervous system is located right above your cerebellum. And this right here, remember, your cerebellum gates. This is the gatekeeper. So information coming up, the cerebellum is going to gate it to see, well, does my brain actually need to know that information? If it's damaged, all the information goes up to your brain and says the cerebellum has no filters. Boom, boom, boom. Yes, yes, yes. Everything here, you get overwhelmed. It stimulates your sympathetic nervous system, which is right in here. Stimulates your sympathetic nervous system, let me get another pen here. Stimulates your sympathetic nervous system, which is right in here, bombards it. And then what happens? You're in this runaway fight or flight mechanism. the flight or fight mechanism. You have all this anxiety. No one knows what's going on. You go to the doctor. They tell you it's all in your head. You're crazy. Here's some antipsychotic medications or whatever it is. At the end of the day, you need a functional medicine approach if you've been floxed that looks at your individual needs. So what is it exactly that I do in my office? It's an individual custom tailored plan based on your needs. No one has the same thumbprint, right? No snowflake is the same. No human body is the same. So in order to get to the root cause of the problem, you have to have a polytherapy approach, many, that is very specific for your needs. So I hope you found value in this. If you're suffering with central nervous system problems, you can get help. There's going to be more information below here to get contact with my office if you so want to do that, or connections for more videos. Take care. I hope you found value in this webinar.